And welcome back to Scale Me Down and to part two of this build, fly and review of this de Havilland Twin Otter from X-Fly Models. Please like and subscribe to support the channel. This kit with optional floats was supplied for review by Steve Webb Models and I'll pop a link in the description below. Now let's get her up on her floats and see how she performs in the water. For this, the kit includes two sets of wire legs and two foam floats. There's already flats filed on the wire parts and they slot into plastic fittings. They fasten with machine screws into metal inserts, but be careful not to over tighten them. To improve the scale appearance and perhaps reduce a bit of drag, I fitted this airfoil section aluminium tube that I painted white with some Yoohoo pour. Now let's disconnect the nose wheel steering and turn it over to remove the wheels. The front struts took a fair bit of force to get them to fit properly. Then we connect up the water rudder servo to the rudder Y lead and tidy up the wiring. Now you're meant to take the nose wheel apart to reuse this plate, but instead I 3D printed and painted a blanking plate to fit. You're also meant to remove and reuse this fairing. But as you can see from these photos of the full size, they're not the right shape anyway. So I drew and 3D printed my own. And these little additions will make switching between floats and wheels a simple 10-minute job. All done, and let's just recheck the centre of gravity. If you think back to part one of the review on wheels, you'll remember I said it was very easy to fly and had plenty of control authority. But when I put her into the water on her floats, my first impressions were not as positive. Because the model is light and it sits high in the water, I found water taxiing hard work and it was easy to tip her over in this 8 mph breeze. However, once up and away, she was again a joy to fly. Of course, there's more drag on floats, but there's still plenty of power, with level flight maintained at half throttle. And slightly more rudder was required with ailerons in the turns. I found the stall and recovery unaffected by the floats, and the rate of climb is still excellent. The spacious fuselage, clear windows and easy handling would make this a perfect model for a first-person view FPV setup. I found the landings very easy flapless. However, as it's so draggy, you'll require a trickle of power all the way to touchdown. However, some flap adds even more drag, and with full flap, without care, it just stops and drops out the sky like an anvil. Some flap also makes the takeoff less predictable. Perhaps the angle of attack is a bit high when on the water. It does mean you can get airborne in short order if you gun it, but notice the wild swing to the left. I think I'll probably bend the front wire struts to reduce the nose up attitude on the water. I much prefer slow, graceful takeoffs, landings and splash and goes, which are very satisfying with this model.
So in conclusion then, this is a really lovely model. It's of an interesting subject and it's a nice, bright, easy to see scheme. Assembly is very quick and easy, and it's very clear it's a high quality kit. In particular, the auto connecting electrical connections at the wing routes, the scale flap and aileron arrangements, and that lovely machine nose leg. Despite being a foam model, it actually represents quite reasonable value for money. I was a little disappointed to see two right hand rotation props rather than counter rotating props to cancel the torque, and the float assembly left me a little cold. Being a foam model, it's difficult to keep pristine, but of course for a float plane, foam's an excellent choice. It's a very easy aeroplane to fly and will make a great second model. On wheels, its short field and rough field performance is excellent. And of course on floats, it's a little bit more challenging. So with this model, you get the versatility and capability of having a two-in-one model, having both floats and wheels. As this model is very similar to the VQ model's twin otter that we reviewed on the channel, it's inevitable that we make some comparisons. The X-Fly twin otter runs on a 6-cell setup, whereas the VQ runs on a 4-cell setup. The VQ model's is quite a bit heavier than the X-Fly, but that means it doesn't get blown about the same in the wind. However, the aileron authority is much softer on the VQ and it flies in a much more scale-like manner, whereas the X-Fly models has much more control authority and better power to weight, so it's a lot sportier. The X-Fly is foam and so it's more difficult to keep pristine. However, all the details are moulded in on the X-Fly, whereas on the VQ they're printed onto the covering, and it also has the opening scale doors and such. The X-Fly is very easy to put together, as you just put together what's in the box and follow the instructions, whereas the VQ models, you have to choose your own equipment to mount. But of course that gives you more choice. And once you've added the bits and pieces on of equipment, actually the costs are very similar. In summary, I prefer the VQ models twin otter on floats, whereas I prefer the X-Fly models on wheels for its short field and rough field performance. If you have either of these models, I'd love to hear your comments in the comments section below. And thanks for watching.